In this lesson, we will discuss the fluid property called viscosity. Viscosity, denoted by the Greek letter mu, is a measure of how well a fluid resists deformation. It also can be thought of as the internal stickiness of the fluid. We can obtain an expression for the viscosity by a simple experiment involving two large plates separated by a small distance b. Fluid is placed in the gap between the two plates. We will keep track of five fluid particles that are in a vertical line at time zero. The bottom plate is stationary, but a force is applied to the upper plate which causes a shear stress on the fluid and makes the upper plate move to the right with a velocity v. After a small amount of time dt has passed, most of the fluid particles have moved toward the right, indicating that the fluid has deformed. We want to determine the relationship between the shear stress tau caused by the force F and the rate of deformation of the fluid. First, we need to mathematically describe the rate of deformation of the fluid. Imagine the fluid particles are divided into numerous layers. Here we only show five layers for clarity, but there would be many more layers in a real fluid. If we carefully examine the fluid in the layer next to the top plate, which is layer 1, and the layer next to the bottom plate, which is layer 5, we would see that those particles move with the same velocity as the plates. So the fluid in layer 1 would move toward the right with a velocity v, and the fluid in layer 5 would be stationary. This is because fluid particles adjacent to a solid surface is in equilibrium with that surface. This equilibrium condition is called the no-slip boundary condition. The fluid between the top and bottom layers obtain velocities between 0 and v as they are dragged by adjacent layers. Examining the lines formed by the fluid particles at time 0 and time dt, we see that the fluid has deformed by a small angle d theta. We call the rate that d theta changes in time the rate of shearing strain, which is also sometimes called the strain rate. This will be our measure of the rate of fluid deformation. Since dt is very small, d theta is very small as well. For small angles, the tangent of the angle is approximately equal to the angle itself, so d theta is approximately tangent d theta. Using trigonometry, the tangent of d theta is equal to the distance traveled by the fluid particle in layer 1 divided by the distance between the two plates. Since the fluid in layer 1 is moving with the speed v, the distance traveled by the fluid in layer 1 is v times dt, and the distance between the plates is b. Plugging in d theta into the equation for the rate of shearing strain, we get v times dt divided by b divided by dt. Eliminating dt in the numerator and denominator gives us v divided by b. Notice that the fluid moves in the x direction but varies in the y direction. That is, the velocity, which we will call little u, is a function of y only. The velocity gradient, du dy, is the rate velocity varies in the y direction. The change in velocity from the top plate to the bottom plate is u evaluated at y equals b minus u evaluated at y equals 0. The distance between the top and bottom plates is b minus 0. The velocity at y equals b is capital V, and the velocity at y equals 0 is 0. So the velocity gradient is equal to v divided by b, which is also equal to the rate of the shearing strain. We still need some way to relate the rate of shearing strain to the shear stress applied to the fluid. Experiments show that the rate of shearing strain increases as the applied shear stress increases. And for many common fluids, such as water, gasoline, and air, the shear stress is approximately proportional to the rate of shearing strain. Since the rate of shearing strain is equal to the velocity gradient, That means for these fluids, the shear stress is proportional to the velocity gradient as well. The constant of proportionality between the applied shear stress tau and the rate of shearing strain du dy is the viscosity of the fluid. So viscosity relates the rate of deformation to the shear stress that is causing the deformation. Fluids that obey this relationship are called Newtonian fluids. The SI units of viscosity are newtons seconds per meter squared, and the BG units are pound force seconds per feet squared. The symbol mu is usually called the absolute viscosity or dynamic viscosity. The absolute viscosity mu, divided by the density rho, appears often in fluid mechanics and is defined as a new variable nu, which is the kinematic viscosity. For liquids, viscosity is a strong function of temperature and decreases rapidly as temperature increases. For gases, viscosity is a weaker function of temperature and increases moderately as temperature increases. As mentioned earlier, for Newtonian fluids, the viscosity mu is a constant of proportionality relating the shear stress and rate of shearing strain. If we were to plot the shear stress versus rate of shearing strain for Newtonian fluids, the relationship would be linear. The viscosity of canola oil is much greater than the viscosity of water at the same temperature, and the canola oil line is much steeper. If water were heated, its viscosity would decrease and the curve would become less steep. Many fluids do not exhibit Newtonian behavior, and their viscosities vary depending upon the applied shear stress. For these fluids, we replace the viscosity mu with the apparent viscosity, mu apparent, in the equation relating shear stress and the rate of shearing strain. The apparent viscosity is the resistance to deformation at a given shear stress. The viscosity of pseudoplastics, sometimes called shear thinning fluids, decreases with increasing applied shear stress. Notice that the slope is relatively high at small shear stresses and decreases as the shear stress gets larger. The viscosity of dilatants, sometimes called shear thickening fluids, increases with increasing shear stress. And Bingham plastics require certain yield shear stress before deformation will occur.